the artistic dream of its founders, to create a theater of excellence concentrating primarily on themes of black life is a reality. The Negro Ensemble Company boasts a total of more than 40 major theater awards. It has produced over 200 new plays. More than 4,000 men and women in all areas of theater arts have passed through its doors, including most of the best and best known black actors in television and film. And a legacy of theater literature, black in subject, but universal in appeal, is being fashioned for future generations. Ensemble Company was founded in 1967 by actor-playwright Douglas Turner Ward, actor Robert Hooks, and theater manager Gerald Crone. Robert Hooks' acting career had gotten off the ground with a part opposite Douglas Turner Ward. Raisin by Lorraine Hansberry had won the New York Drama Critics Award for Best Play of 1959.
And I know you're working on your autobiography.
Indeed.
For Me.
My book is called Life for Me at the Crossroads, the subtitle of Art, Culture, Politics, and the Civil Rights Movement.
Wow.
And that because I was right at the axis of all of this.
Now, you're also working on a one-man show.
I met Langston when I back in the 60s. This was in his, later in his life. And the Harlem Renaissance was always... I think I was there in another life because I was so passionate about this period of the Harlem Renaissance. And I've studied Langston's work, all of his work, not just his poetry. And I decided that a one-man show is in order before I'm out of here. I got to do something special. So I'm putting together a one-man show on Langston Hughes's poetry and also the main character that Langston, the everyman, simple.
Trouble is here. He's street smart and steel hard. He's a healer, a fixer.
My name's T, baby.
Wears $600 suits, drives a $10,000 car, and he carries two guns, one to stop trouble and one to make trouble. He was born in the ghetto and raised in the streets. He's been a man since he was a kid, and Trouble is this man's name. If you got trouble, call T and leave a message. Service is prompt, efficient, and deadly. Trouble Man. You jive him, he'll wash you away. Trouble Man. Rated R. Restricted.
To those who have challenged my statements as to my own antecedents, I now put the lie. To those who have accused me of falsely claiming the status of fugitive slave, as if it were an honor to be won rather than a pestilence to be borne, I cry shame. I was born a slave. And by the laws of Maryland, I am still a slave. My name is Frederick Augustus Bailey. I was born in Talbot County, son of Harriet Bailey, and property of Captain Anthony, who later gave me as a present to his son-in-law, Captain All, who now resides in Baltimore. I have written it all in here, and as Captain All will soon have a copy, perhaps you may wish a copy too.
Frederick.
The price of my narrative is 50 cents. I do not commend it as literature, but as a source of facts concerning the most monstrous institution ever conceived for the degradation of man.
Today I went up on the hill to see my little boy. I took him up for a ride. And as we were moving along the streets, he asked me where all the people were coming from. And I said, from work, going home, going to the store, coming back from the store. And then we went out to see the river. And then he asked me about the water, the ships, the weeds, everything. That kid threw so many questions at me, I got dizzy. But he was just a little dark kid, discovering for the first time that there are things in the world like stones and trees. Well, it got late and dark. So I took him home, and his mother and I watched him fall asleep. Man, that was a beautiful sight. Then I took his mother into my arms, and I tried to tell her about all the things I wanted to feel, but couldn't. And then she looked up at me, and I got that same question all over again. Will you marry me and be the father of your son? I tried to move away from her, but she dug her fingernails into my shoulders, and I struck her once, twice, again and again with this hand. And her face was a bloody mess. And I felt real bad about that. So I said, yes, I'll marry you, woman. Yes, yes, yes. And I walked out into the streets, trembling with the knowledge that now I have a little boy who I must walk through the park with every Sunday, who one day just may blow my head off. And an abiding wife who on a given evening may get herself caught in the bed of another man, and I could be sealed in a dungeon until dead. I was found lying in a well of blood on the day I was born, but I have been kind. So I did it. I did it, man. I told her that I would always be there with her. And that got me to shaking all over. And the last time I trembled like that, I killed a man.
Now, you ought to know what to do to hush her up. What good is a mother who can't even shut up her own daughter?
I told you she won't let me lay hands on her. Where's Lula? Didn't you call her?
I told you I can't get the call through.
Try again.
It's no use. I tried numerous times. I can't even get through to the switchboard. Now, you got to quiet her down yourself. So get in there and clamber up before I lose my patience.
She just screams louder.
She's wet and soppy.
Yes, stinks something awful. Oh, I can't stand all that filth and odor.
She needs a dirty change. Now you go and change it.
How do you send me to when I don't know how? Suppose I faint.
Well, let her blast away. I'm getting out of here.
Oh, you can't leave me here like this.
Just watch me. You see this nice split-level cottage, peachy furniture, multicolored TV, hi-fi set and the rest? Well, how you think I scraped them together while you curl up on your fat little fanny? By getting out of here, not only on time, but earlier. Beating a frantic crew of nice young executives to the punch. Getting there firstest with the mostest brown nosing you ever saw. Now, if I goof one day, just one day, you reckon I'd stay ahead? No. Why, there'd be a wolf pack trampling over my prostrate body, racing to replace my smiling face against the boss's left rump. No, ma'am. I'm zooming out of here on time, like always. And what's more, you gonna fix me some breakfast. I'm hungry.
But!
No buts about it!
Peterman, Peterman, Peterman. That sun is hot and plenty bright. Let's get down to business and get home tonight. Bid 'em in, bid 'em in. Now, auctioning slaves is a real high hop. Bring that young girl, Roy. She's good for a start. Now, here's a real good buy, only about 15. Her great-grandmammy was a Dahomey queen. Just look at her face. She sure ain't homely, like Sheba in the Bible. She's black, but comely. Bid 'em in, bid 'em in. Don't mind them tears. That's one of her tricks. $5.50's the bid. Who'll say $6? She's healthy and strong and well equipped. Makes a fine lady's maid when she's properly whipped. Bid 'em in, bid 'em in. $6.50. Don't be slow. $7 is the bid. Gonna let her go. At $7, she's going, going, gone. Pull her down, Roy. Bring the next one on. Bid 'em in, bid 'em in.
Yes, Mama.
I was wrong. I was wrong.
Mama, whatever you done, you did it because you thought it was right. Don't fret yourself about it, please. Mama. Mama?
Ha, 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 ha,
Oh, jeepers, my heart is beating.
You remember that song?
What song?
Jeepers, creepers, where did you get them peepers? Jeepers, creepers, where did you get them eyes?
Oh, I do remember. Oh, minutes can seem like hours when your traction's terrific.
I wonder something about you.
Oh, what do you wonder?
If the attraction would still be terrific if I was to tell you that the talk and suspicion about me is based on fact.
What talk and suspicion?
That I have colored blood in me.
Oh, I know there's no truth in that.
Did you ever try being what you are? I mean, like, I am what I am and that's it. And anybody who doesn't like it, well...
Go on. I am what I am and what?
That's all. You do that and look what happens. Nobody can threaten you. There are no bad guys to push you around. You are what you are.
And just like that, all my troubles are over.
Mr. Gaffer, nobody's troubles are over.
Very easy for you to say.
Why? Because I can't hide what I am anyway.
You've all done remarkable service under the most difficult conditions. You'll be receiving Starfleet's highest commendation. And more importantly, extended shore leave. That is all but you, Mr. Scott. They need your wisdom on the new Excelsior. Report there tomorrow as captain of engineering.
With all appreciation, sir, I prefer to supervise the refit of Enterprise.
I'm afraid that won't be necessary.
But, sir...
I'm sorry, Mr. Scott, but there will be no refit.
Admiral, I don't understand. The Enterprise is not...
Jim, the Enterprise is 20 years old. We feel her day is over.
But we had requested. We'd hoped to take her back to Genesis.
That is out of the question.
You know about Eden?
Yeah, I know about Eden. Hey, nice to meet you. She wants to learn, and you say she's hopeless.
That's the way it is. Look, we'll pick up on where we left off later.
Why can't you tutor her, Will?
Oh, for Christ's sakes, Joe. With the years of education missing there, the gap's too wide for tutoring to fill. The odds are against it. Believe me. Major, major effort, then.
Yeah. About as major as me convincing the others to get on board and ride with you into this new mega deal you got in mind. I'll be willing to give it my best shot. Best shot for best shot.
They aren't even soldiers.
They are soldiers, Captain. Bona fide members of the armed forces of the United States.
A soldier fights.
A soldier does what he is ordered to do. Every one of those men volunteered to fight, to die for his country. They've been here 3 years, Captain. 3 years waiting to face a gun. You know where their orders have been, huh? This is a service company, Carter. Sanitation detail, mess detail, burial detail. Did you ever wonder what happened to those trenches once you leave, huh? Those stinking trenches that you can't stand to go near because they make you vomit? B Company fills them up with lye and mud and then goes someplace else to dig another. Don't tell me they're not soldiers because they don't fight.